Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Dean, and this is my review of Nokia 6. Sorry, the wrong one. The price started at 1699 RMB, that's approximately $250. So it's a budget phone, still I know it's been exciting for many people. Back then I was a Nokia fan myself. I had Nokia N81, E72, and Lumia 730, which I didn't like and returned shortly after. So which one is your favorite Nokia phone? Let me know in the comment down below. Okay, Nokia is back with Android. Now, it's not their first Android attempt, there was Nokia X, but the system was too much modified, which was literally painful to use. But this time, it's running Android 7.0. More specifically, it's based on Snapdragon Mark 14. I don't know about you guys, but I tend to like the stock Android over those iOS wannabe ROMs on Chinese phones. By the way, there's no way to install Google services at this point, but it will be soon. Okay, before we start, let's go through some background information. So the brand Nokia was sold to this Finnish company HMD, along with some patents, and it's manufactured and shipped by a Chinese company called FIH Mobile, also known as Foxconn. And they also make phones for Xiaomi and Huawei, so what's really Nokia about this phone is just the brand. It's a similar situation as BlackBerry and TCL, also the early OnePlus phones. We'll get to that in the future. But as average consumers, let's focus on the product itself. So my first impression of this phone was, wow, this is bigger than I thought. And second impression was, yeah, I like the way it looks. So the width of Nokia 6 is 75.8 millimeters. That's pretty big among all the 5.5 inch phones nowadays. And that's because there's a thick layer of rubber around the screen, which gives a really good protection when you drop it. We'll get to that later. So the aesthetic of the phone is kind of conservative. It has a symmetrical brick design. The front is covered by Gorilla Glass 3 with 2.5D edges, and then you have the aluminum unibody covering matte black finish, which tend to attract fingerprints a lot. Speaking of which, the fingerprint reader is the indentation on the glass panel. It's similar to the one on Xiaomi 5S. The unlock speed is not that fast, but you wouldn't notice as long as you don't put it next to the fast ones. Going around the sides, on the left side, there's a SIM card tray. On the right side, you have a power button and volume rockers. On top, there's nothing but a headphone jack. And on the bottom, you have a microphone, a micro USB charging port instead of USB Type-C. Now that's a bummer, and a speaker. Okay, the screen. Nokia 6 has a 5.5 inch 1080p IPS display. Trust me, I've seen horrible screens on some budget Chinese phones, but this is not one of them. It's not as colorful as the AMOLED display, but it's crisp and color accurate. And the viewing angle is good too. Now build quality. Nokia phones are always marketed to be durable, and it does feel durable in hand. The keys are firm, the travel is a bit short. Nokia claims that this phone can survive 200 times drop test at the lab. Well, there's no way for me to find out, I'm not gonna use it to crack nuts or something, but I did have a happy accident myself. So I was filming the phone, and there was a strong wind, the phone fell out from 1 meter high on a solid rock. So at that moment, I was like, oh great, now I have to buy a new one. But not only it survived, it only has a few marks on the corner and a tiny scratch on the screen. So thumbs up to Nokia for remaining the standard. Well, now it's the time to stress the elephant in the room. Nokia 6 is powered by Snapdragon 430. Now, I know it's a relatively weak processor, because it starts with number 4, but still it has 8 core, it has Adreno 505 GPU, which is more powerful than Adreno 405 on Snapdragon 616. See, most people don't need that much horsepower. I have a Galaxy S7 as my daily driver, and I only have one game installed. So it's more about other things like battery life, a camera, and audio. So let's get to that. So the battery capacity of Nokia 6 is 3000 mAh. It's a little small and it doesn't have rapid charge, but the benefit of having a weak processor is that it costs less power, so this phone can easily get you throughout the day. And let me know if you want me to do the battery test. Now audio. Nokia 6 has one front-facing speaker next to the Nokia logo and one at the bottom. That's not ideal, but it's enhanced by Dolby Atmos technology, so the sound quality is pretty amazing. I would say it's far better than the S7 I have. Now camera, it has a 16 megapixel camera with f2.0 aperture. I like the pictures I took in daylight, it has nice color reproduction, it's not too saturated as the camera on S7 tends to be, but it has a smaller sensor, that means it's gonna suck in low light scenarios. The more detailed camera review will come later. Okay, closing thoughts. Nokia 6 has solid build quality, respectfully good audio, and nearly stock Android experience. However, it has a relatively weak processor, a small battery, and it's only available in China, so it only supports the 4G frequency in China. but the good news is there will be more powerful models, and eventually they will sell their products across the globe. So that was it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. We'll catch up in the next one.